Will the actual now passed $3.5 trillion reconciliation thing actually pass? Well, there is reason to believe that it might not, because at least one Senate Democrat, Kyrsten Sinema, has already said that she will not support a final $3.5 trillion price tag, despite voting to advance a budget resolution of that scope. So she said, we can go forward with it, but I'm not gonna support it. Not gonna support. Now, how much will she support? I don't know. Will it be 3.4 trillion? Will it be 1 trillion? Will it be literally nothing? Stay tuned. But here's the thing, that's sort of a vague thing. We have more information from Joe Manchin, who this morning released this. I have serious concerns about the grave consequences facing West Virginians and every American family if Congress decides to spend another $3.5 trillion. Blah, blah, blah. That's not literally what it said, but I was getting sick of it. These are not indications of an economy that requires trillions in additional spending. Every elected leader has chosen to make difficult decisions. Adding trillions of dollars more to our nearly $29 trillion of national debt without any consideration of the negative effects on our children and grandchildren is one of the decisions that has become far too easy in Washington. I urge my colleagues to seriously consider this reality as this budget process unfolds in the coming weeks and months. So yes, he's very, very worried about the effect on our children and grandchildren. I mean, he does literally everything to stop us from dealing with the climate change, which is going to wreck the lives of his children and grandchildren. But in this case, he pretends to care about it. So JR, are they just going to strip out a bunch of stuff? Are they going to weaken the tax increases designed to pay for it? Or are we actually looking at, they're going to ruin it so much that the House progressives will not support it, which means we won't get the bipartisan one either. Like, there's a lot of pressure being thrown around. I asked this morning on Twitter, Ryan Grimm said, he was talking about this process. I asked him, do they actually care if both get voted down? He believes that they do, that Sinema and Manchin do not want to lose this bipartisan bill. I personally care that, think that Kyrsten Sinema doesn't care about literally anything, but yeah. What do you think?
Well, yeah, Joe Manchin, it's a split between those two. Joe Manchin cares about making sure that if something happens, he actually doesn't care how watered down or degraded it gets. As long as there's something in that says Joe Manchin made this bipartisan deal happen. Again, this has been his objective from the beginning. That's why he throws in his stupid statement. You know, these consequences, grave consequences facing West Virginians. What do West Virginians specifically have to do with this that no one else does? Why do we point out West Virginians specifically outside the fact that you're from there and you have to make sure that you inject your name into every discussion about I'm from West Virginia. I'm West Virginia. You know, West Virginians need some representation that helps them, that actually helps them and not tells them what they want when it actually doesn't help them. That's what all these politicians like to do. Anyway, so he may want to make sure something's in that has his name on it. Maybe Sinema's just like, you know, as long as I'm seen as this maverick that's pushing back against my party, enough Republicans will like me and I can continue to get elected here in Arizona, because she's trying to read the winds of the political winds to make sure that it fits her narrative. There's one part about that statement. Every time a politician puts out a statement, it's very specific and they know every word for what it's supposed to be there for, is a meaning behind it. When it's a statement, when they're saying something, maybe they could mess up. But he points out that every elected official leader is chosen to make difficult decisions. Does that mean the difficult decision is to say, yeah, we need this 3.5 trillion, or that no, we don't need it? Because if you're saying no, which it sounds like is what he's saying, because he wants to lower it, it's a difficult decision because it's good that we get the 3.5 and we should lower it. I'm just not sure what's the difficult decision. Like, why is it? It's difficult if you're going against the American people because it's not helping them anymore. Are you saying you're one of those guys? Or is it difficult if you say, yeah, let's get to 3.5 trillion, but usually difficult decisions are good ones. I would think when you're pointing out that it's a difficult decision for a politician to make, it means it's gonna help people, but it's a little bit tough because people are gonna judge me for it.
I don't know. Ryan Grimm said
it's a weird question. I get it.
Manchin just wants a news cycle for everything that happens of him standing strong, but then eventually going along with it. And if that is actually what happens, then good. There's a lot of worse outcomes for this process. If he just wants to waste some of our time and cut it a little bit, then I will be perfectly happy with that, I guess. There are much worse things, like he could tank the entire thing and we get literally nothing. That would be terrible because the stakes are high.
Well, and honestly,
we'll see. And Sinema might be even less. Like, Manchin might be a little bit more predictable, at least predictably awful, but he might be more predictable than someone like Sinema.
Yeah, it's one of the things. If it gets watered down, destroyed to the point where even, you know, Democrats and progressives will be like, you know, this is crazy. Then if it gets shot down to them, that's a perfect thing for Republicans. They're like, we wasted all this time. We can blame it on Democrats for shooting down a bipartisan bill that we said we're on board for. And then maybe we can win and we can campaign off of that. Like, that's that is the perfect scenario for them.
It might be. I hope I'm wrong. I hope we'll pass one and it's like, hey, it's 3.7 trillion. John, you were an idiot. Good, I hope so. I kind of doubt it, but I hope so.
For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.